The last guy who flew to this village never made it there, so it's been almost a month since they've gotten supplies. I bet they're gonna be happy to see us. Let's get going. I'll fill you in some more once we're on our way. Take off and fly north. The camp we're headed to is about 26 miles from here. Have us haul equipment and supplies from their base camp out to whatever village they happen to be at. I'm not sure exactly what they're doing, but they couldn't do it without our help. That's pretty thick jungle down there. Set the throttles for cruise power. I usually cruise with 30 inches of manifold pressure and 2200 RPM. shore of that lake. We'll land and pick up some cargo, then take it to the village. Okay, taxi over to the dock and we can load up. About 6 miles northwest of here. The village is on the south side of the lake. When we get there, I'll unload the plane and go into the village. They still owe us for a few flights. We're gonna have to buy fuel pretty soon. the lake. See the village on the south side? Check gear up for a water landing. See that makeshift dock made out of tree limbs and leaves? Taxi up to it and we can unload. Okay, you stay with the plane. Back in a minute.
Place? Well, if our deductions are correct, and I'm pretty sure they are, we've narrowed the probable location down to an area about 11 miles southwest of here.
Well, you heard the lady. The probable location is 11 miles to the southwest. Let's go.
Avoid bringing theoretical preconceptions to my work, but in this case, it's paid off. The inhabitants of this region have long spoken about ancients who worshipped the anaconda, one of the largest snakes in the world. In the annals of the conquistadors, there is mention of a site the ancients called Belly of the Snake. Now, my theory has long been that it's a metaphor for the midsection of a winding lake, and a few days ago, an elder in the village confided to me that he has faint childhood memories of snake-like statues lining a river. I showed him a map, and he pointed to a long, narrow lake not far from here, and that's where we're headed.
So we're looking for giant snake statues.
Yes. I should mention one more thing. When I asked the old man if he remembered seeing the temple itself, he shook his head and he told me never to go there. When I asked him why, he said, "Maldito."
What does that mean?
Cursed. Of course, I'm a scientist, so I don't really believe in curses. And yet, I must admit that I'm intrigued.
sure. Let's land and taxi over. Check gear up. Looks pretty authentic to me. Better tighten your seatbelt. Looks like we're having some trouble with the flight controls. Make sure the battery is on. What's going on with this thing? The attitude indicator just failed too. Like everything is failing. We just lost the altimeter. Use the radio altimeter from now on. Your right side. Feather the prop.
We're gonna make it, right? What do all those lights mean?
Not to be rude, but we sort of have our hands full at the moment. Can you hold the questions until we're on the ground?
Sure. Sorry.
Engine, loss of power. Raise the flaps. Feels like both aren't coming down. Not sure. I've been flying for more than 20 years, and I've never seen anything like that. Flight controls, instruments, electrical, power plant. It just doesn't make sense.
Well, I can't thank you two enough. You handled the situation very professionally. I'll make sure the museum makes all this trouble worth your while.
Our, pleasure. I just hope we're not the ones flying that thing to Lima.